Hey y'all, so let's jump right into this video. So today I am pressed for time on my way to my nephew's football game, so I gotta get dressed ASAP. So the first thing I'm gonna do is lay my edges using this Black Panther edge control that I got off of Amazon. And so this is my first time using it, you guys, so we're gonna see how it works together. First things first, I'm just applying a little bit of Lotta Body lotions, give my hair a little bit of moisture. Next, we're going right into the edge control, and honestly, spoiler alert, I really like this edge control. It hasn't flaked up on me yet or caused any like white cast. It held very well. Like I said, I was outside at a football game and my edges, my hair lasts for some hours, maybe like 8 hours without budging. So I really like this. I will put it down in the description box and it'll also be linked in my Amazon store. So check it out if you're looking for a new edge control for your headband wigs, y'all. I think this combination really worked for me. You can tell how sleek and slick my hair is. I like to pop a wig cap on underneath my headband wigs, especially when I'm laying my edges, just because they don't move, so they don't start to revert and it kind of holds them in place. So because I love my Goldwell Jam, you guys know how I feel about my Legume Jam so far, I went on ahead and applied it on top of the Black Panther edge control because I figured this was a step I was gonna do anyways, and I just wanted to see how this combination would work together. And I still get this question pretty often of, do I relax my edges? Y'all, I've only relaxed my edges twice since I've been natural, and the last time I did that was about 4 years ago. My hairline isn't very thick, but my little baby hairs are pretty long, so I think that's kind of what throws people off, but I just want to clarify for you guys. So this is how we're looking, y'all. I just rubbed it a little bit just to make sure it stayed in place. And from here, I'm just gonna tie my hair down just for a few minutes. So moving on to this Wiggins headband wig, you guys. So they sent me two little headbands and a little bag to store my wig in. And this is their 24-inch curly headband wig. And the hair on this wig felt really good, not like a synthetic feel or anything like that. So we were good to go. So the inside of this wig comes with little combs. So you get three at the top and then two at the bottom, and the strap, so the satin band on this, does not go all the way around. It's mainly like right by the combs. And here's just the really pretty curls for you guys to see. So all you do is, and you guys heard me say this a billion times, you just pop these little combs right on your hair. So you open them up and then all I'm gonna do is just push them back, which is what I'm doing right here, and then snap them down so that they're nice and secure. And because I don't have super thick hair, the smaller combs are just more comfortable for me. And as far as the Velcro, you just lay one on top of the other, very self-explanatory, and you are good to go. So I don't have the exact density, but I will make sure it's down below in the description box for you guys. But this wig, this was a lot of hair on this headband wig. I didn't think it would be this much. So if you like big curls, big volume, big hair, you would definitely like this particular wig. And I realized that the construction of this wig was really nice. That's why I was kind of feeling the scalp part or the base of it, because I'm starting to realize, the more I review these headband wigs, I feel like they've changed in such a short amount of time. And I feel like they've changed for the better. Now, this is my first time reviewing and seeing and feeling and all that good stuff a Wiggins headband wig. So maybe they could have always been like this. Theirs could have always been this great as far as structure goes. But the cap on this was really nice, you guys. The curls fell perfect and it just fit really nice on my head and very comfortable. So this is one way you can wear it just as is and leave the black headband just as your headband alone. And here you can see just how full it is, or you can pop a different headband on. They sent me this little bejeweled, bedazzled, I don't know the wording for it, headband, just to give yourself a little different look depending on the occasion. And to switch it up just to give you guys something a little bit more bun, just two little space buns. And just in case you've been wondering why has there been such an influx of headband wigs, it's just because there's a lace shortage going on right now. But honestly, it's been nice giving my hairline a little break from all the free spray and all that stuff that goes into lace wigs. And another option is just adding a different headband, and you can just wear it just like this, just down if you wanted to, just give yourself a little something different, or half up, half down, which is one of my favorite styles when it comes to headband wigs. And the last look you'll see in just a minute is just a high bun. And I just want you guys to know I rarely got any poking out business like I have been when it comes to headband wigs. So if you wanted to wear your hair in a high bun, that is also an option. So all in all, I'm pretty impressed by this headband wig from Wiggins Hair. I don't work with them very often, y'all, but this was pretty good. This was not bad at all. Definitely one of my favorites and one of the best fitting so far. So make sure you check the description box for all the details on this wig. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I will talk to you in my next one. Bye.